Is our God throughout the earth, his judgment prevails. he must, he may bow for a thousand generations, which he entered into with Abraham, and by his oath to Isaac. The Lord remembers his covenant forever. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. If today you hear his voice, pardon not your hearts. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever keeps my word never see death." So the Jews said to him, "Man, we are sure that you are possessed. Abraham died, as did the prophets, yet you say, whoever keeps my word will never taste death. Are you greater than our father Abraham who died? Or the prophets who died? Who do you make yourself out to be?" Jesus answered, "If I glorify myself, my glory is worth nothing. But it is my Father who glorifies me, of whom you say he is our God. You do not know him, but I know him. And if I should say that I do not know him, I would be like you, the liar. But I do know him, and I keep his word. Abraham, the father, rejoiced to see my day. He saw it and was glad." So the Jews said to him, You are not yet 50 years old, and have seen Abraham?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, before Abraham came to be, I am." So they picked up stones to throw at him. But Jesus hid and went out of the temple near him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Today's scripture reading talk about Abraham. The prophet Isaiah speaks of Abraham as the rock from which the people of Israel hewn. No one in the whole story of the people of Israel was greater than Abraham. Abraham was the father of the nation of Israel. The question that the Jewish leaders put to Jesus was almost his disbelief. "Are you greater than our father Abraham?" It was as if they were saying to Jesus, "You can't seriously be claiming to be greater than our father Abraham." Jesus replies, "One whose father was God, it is my father who glorifies me." As Son of God, Jesus is indeed greater than Abraham. Jesus indeed is greater than anyone in the whole universe. As the Son who was with God in the beginning and from the beginning, before anything or anyone was created, Jesus was certainly greater than Abraham. Before Abraham came to be, there was so much more to Jesus than to Abraham. The Jewish authorities pick up stones to throw at him. The claims that he was making himself were experienced as a threat to the religious tradition of the time. The claims that he makes himself in the Gospels, especially in the Gospel of John, can never be fully contained by any religious tradition, including our Christian tradition. There's always what Jesus maybe can give expression to in our own religious tradition. That more need to be experienced as threatening in any way, but rather as a source of consolation. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, who is God's beloved Son, and who gave his life for the human race, for sinners, is indeed more loving, more powerful, more merciful, more just than we could ever imagine. Because the Lord is more than we could ever imagine him to be, and we entrust ourselves to his care and guidance with hopeful confidence. If we do that, especially in these dark, challenging times, we will discover that the Lord will not disappoint us or abandon us. Now let us stand for prayer with faith. Let us together lift our hearts and mind to God as we present our petitions.
That the Church may continue to be purified and sanctified through the grace and mercy of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
The Lord, hear our prayer.
That national and international leaders may be empowered by the Holy Spirit in serving their people as Christ came to serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have turned from God may receive from him the grace of conversion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this Lenten season may be time to grow in the gifts of God has given us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may be united with Christ in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In our special attention today is for Luca Tran Nguyen. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we continue to pray for those who suffer from the outbreaks, especially those who are currently sick. And we pray that the Lord to heal them of this sickness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for our sickness, our professionals, official and all who are serving the common good in this difficult and certain time, that they feel wisdom and understanding and compassion. Let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in times of goodness, our merciful and beloved Father, we will strengthen our faith and trust in his goodness and divine providence. We pray to you.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our precious Father would touch all affected by the current outbreak with healing and peace. We pray to you.
Lord, help us.
Blessed are you, Lord, of all creation, and your witness we have received, bread and all of you, the earth and your human hands, become us, bread and life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, of all creation, and your goodness we have received, and why we offer you to divine and open hands, become us rich in prayer.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, the brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and voice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our hand, for the praise and glory of his name,
our good and good of our Holy Church. Look with favor, Lord, we pray, and we sacrifice your offerings that they may be perfect in your conversion, and the salvation of all the world, through Christ. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you more to the bread and life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that we have elders worthy to be in the presence ministered to you. Humbly we pray that remember what the church throughout the world to bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, and Timothy and Thomas, our sister bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also the brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, Have mercy on us, all we pray, through the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, we have each you throughout the ages, we merit to be glorious with your life, and the praises we pray to you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, God, and your Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
In the Savior's commandment, walk by a multitude of them, say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray from every evil, receiving with peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and stay in all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. With the keeping of the power and glory of your spirit, I am aware. Lord Jesus Christ, I send you apostles, peace I give you, peace I give you. Look upon our sins, but the faith of the Church, and graciously grant her peace and in the accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called on the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, the God of Jesus, which is the church of my
group, and when we say the word, which will share with you. God did not spare his own son, but him and him of us all, with him he has given us all things. Now, I would like to take this opportunity to pray with you at home in prayer, receive spiritual Holy Communion. When the faith of my mother gave me to Mass and receive Holy Communion. So let us pray together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to become spiritually into my heart. Let us pray. Lord, as we are saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by his same sacrament, with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you,
Holy Spirit.
Bow down before the gift.
Be gracious to the people when we pray, and as from day to day they reject what does not please you, they may reveal and stand in the light of your commands, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we pray together the prayers of Michael the Archangel. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, your protection against us, the stand of the devil. May God continue to be prayed with our friends and family hosts. Let the grand power of God cast in our sin and all evil spirit rule over our world, seeking good souls. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Holy Spirit.
And when you God bless you, Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth and ask
them. Thanks be to God.